Hey everybody, it's Frank from Motorvate. I've got a really big update to share with you. Okay, here we are on page one. We've got our engine coolant temperature in the top left, engine oil temperature in the top right, air fuel ratio for bank one in the bottom left, and the engine oil pressure. And we can see as we rev it, the gauges respond. Sorry for the vibration, clearly I need a better camera mount and we'll look into that. Okay, hit cruise control twice and we get to page two. Here we have air fuel ratio of bank one and bank two, engine coolant temperature and engine oil temperature. This is a page that was designed for when you're on the track. There's really three important things you want to know. Air fuel ratios to make sure you're not running lean, coolant temperature and oil temperature. Okay, I'll hit the cruise control button twice again. There's our wheel speed, not much to say there. Hit cruise twice again. Here we have our fuel PSI, our engine oil pressure, manual transmission oil temperature, and differential oil temperature. These are all the data items coming from the Bluetooth sensor server. Now you've seen these four pages before, but the next few pages are all new. We'll get to them right now. Here we have the mass airflow for bank one, bank two in grams per second, air intake temperature, and the manifold absolute pressure sensor, which is also known as a boost sensor. You can see the gauges respond nicely. We'll go to the next page. Again, we've got MAF 1 and 2 in grams per second and throttle body 1 and 2. It's kind of neat to see how they are the same but different depending upon the actual throttle position. I don't know what much more to say other than that, but it's just another screen that allows you to sort of correlate the two. Go to the next page here, throttle body one and two, accelerator pedal, and ignition timing. It's quite interesting for the ignition timing. When you're cruising along at low RPM, say 2000 top gear, the ignition timing is like 52, 53 degrees. It's really, really quite high. Next page, here we have short-term fuel trim, bank one, bank two, and long-term fuel trim, bank one and bank two. So this is a single page that will tell you your fuel trims. I was going to add in two more numbers, one for each bank, that would be the total fuel trim, but I don't have room on the page. I may redesign it a little bit to show that, but for right now, that's there. Next page, air fuel ratio, bank one, bank two, and the rear O2 sensor voltage. You can see it responding there a little bit. Next page, tire pressures. Yes, we are going to have real-time tire pressures. And this has been validated on a G37X. I can't do it on my car because I've got my winter rims on, which don't have the TPMS sensors. But I did meet up with a good friend, Andy, and we verified in his car, and it does work just fine. Next page. Here we have torque, as in engine torque. Calculated engine torque is on the car's network, and that's for the automatic transmission, the all-wheel drive module, and also for the traction control module. On the top right, we have steering angle. So we can see that right here, nice and responsive. Now, did you notice how engine torque changed as well? Well, when you first turn the steering wheel, this power steering pump's got a little bit more work to do. So it has to increase the torque and then decrease it real quick. Bottom left is all-wheel drive percentage. For those that have a G37X, this will show you how much torque is going to your front axle. On the G37X, the maximum is 50%, but the way the gauge is laid out, at zero, the car is rear-wheel drive, and at 100%, the car is all-wheel drive. So we're sort of looking at it as a percentage of all-wheel drive. On the bottom right, we have side G. The car has a built-in G sensor. For example, if you read the owner's manual, it will mention to you that when you're in a corner and you're going through it, the G sensor will tell the transmission to hold the gear, because usually that's what you want to do. When you're cornering and you're starting to pull some G's, you don't want to have the car upset by the transmission changing a gear. So we have tapped into that. Next page, engine coolant temperature, engine oil temperature, transmission oil temperature, and differential oil temperature. This is kind of like a temperature page, is kind of what I was thinking. Next page. This is all for automatic transmission G37s only. So we've got the transmission fluid temperature in the top left, input shaft RPM, output shaft RPM, which is actually your drive shaft speed, and the current gear. Now, for the current gear, it's not park, reverse, neutral. It is the gear between 1 to 7 that the transmission is actually in. So that's really quite neat. Now, why have input shaft and output shaft RPM? Well, from here you can get a sense of torque converter lockup, and you can also start to get an idea of the gear ratio that your transmission is in, because the input to output RPM will change. Now, in the very middle, you can see where it says TCL. That's torque converter lockup. So when you're driving along and your torque converter locks up, because the torque converter actually has a hydraulic clutch inside of it, and that's what they use to get better fuel economy. So when that says TCL, the torque converter is locked. It's like a clutch fully released. It's as in the pedal's fully up, the clutch is fully engaged. Then when the clutch is slipping, in the torque converter, it'll be TCS for slipping or sliding or however you want to look at it. Okay, next page. Here we have the brake line pressure. How cool is that? The outside air pressure around the car, the barometer, cruise. So when you're using the cruise control and you set your speed, it will display on the gauge your current cruise control set speed. I don't know if it's all that useful, but it was kind of neat the couple of times that I did that. Okay, and we have the outside temperature just because why not? Next page. Here we have the rad fan duty cycle. Right now the car is sitting in -5, so unless I'm idling for a lot longer, that won't be on. Bottom left, we have the voltage that it sees. So that's kind of a nice little gauge right there. The top right is engine horsepower, and the bottom right is engine torque. On the car's network, it broadcasts the calculated engine torque. And that's used by the automatic transmission, the all-wheel drive module, and the traction control module. So since I know the engine torque and I know the engine RPM, I can calculate the engine horsepower. So that's it right there. Now, you may be wondering, well, why is it zero? The engine's running, it can't be zero. It's probably point something, but since it's not as high as one, because if you remember the formula for horsepower, it is engine RPM times torque divided by 5252. However, if I give it a little bit of gas, we can see that it does respond. Okay, last page. Here we have the air intake temperature on the top left. Bottom left is the air pressure outside the car, the barometer or station pressure as it's known as. And on the top right, we have the cubic feet per minute of how much air is going through the engine right now. That is calculated by the air intake temperature and the outside air pressure. And from that, I create a conversion factor that I use, and then I apply that against the mass airflow sensors in grams per second, and we are able to calculate the actual CFM of the air around the car going through it. So really, I calculate the intake manifold air density, and then I multiply that by how much air is going through your mass airflow sensors. Now, I'm hoping to test this and see exactly how high it goes. But again, it's snowing right now and I can't use anywhere near half throttle, otherwise the traction control kicks in. And again, on the bottom right is the total math. So I've taken math 1, math 2, and added it together. Come back here to page 1. And those are the 16 pages that we now have on this gauge. Now, what's also nice is whatever page you are on, when you turn the car off and start it, of course it restarts on that page. That's to be expected. Also, a big problem with aftermarket gauges is, well, you gotta find the wire for dimming and all that. However, because this is on the car's network, watch this. I'm going to put the headlights on and it dims. So headlights are off. That is super cool. Anyways, just wanted to share that with you. Next steps for me, finalize the hardware, design the enclosure, I've got a couple different options for displays. I need to put together some other test modules, and so you can sort of see exactly what my picture is in my head of the final product. But at least now you have an idea of the functionality that we're going after. I just wanted to put together almost like a full catalog of what's available, and now you've seen that in motion. And what I will do down the road is I'll get a better camera mount, and I'll go out when it's not snowing, and we can see the gauges live as I'm going around a roundabout for the side G, some full throttle acceleration to see the horsepower and torque values, as well as the CFM going through the engine, the cubic feet per minute. Anyways, that's all for now. I'm very excited with how all of this is turning out, and I've got more work to do, but just wanted to show you some progress. All right, thanks everybody.